What's up, guys? Scammers are out there. Don't fall for it. I'm gonna go through probably one of the most popular scams that I get hit with every single day so that you guys are aware and you don't fall for scammers. Let's get into it. First off, I've been getting scam emails easily since like 2010, 2012 when I first originally started being a DJ. As soon as I initially put out my like Facebook page and my information online that I was a DJ, I got scam calls. Scam emails in particular. If you are a young DJ and you're starting off, you're probably gonna start getting these. If you've been in the game, you've already had these. So I'm gonna go through probably one of the most popular ones that I've seen over the years since I started back in like 2010, 2012. And the main reason for this is because I like to fuck with them a little bit. I decided it'd be funny to post like my email conversations with these guys. I know they're scams from the beginning, just cause I've got these so many times, but I wanted to post them on like Instagram. I've been posting them on my Instagram. Follow me on Instagram, I'm really close to 6K. But overwhelmingly, a lot of you guys were not aware of these scams or haven't got these emails, or actually a couple guys sadly have fallen for these scams. It was really a topic that a lot of people were like, you need to make a video on. So we're talking about it here, let's jump into it. So I'm gonna have my editor Joe pop up some screenshots of some of the emails that I've got from these scammers in the past, just a couple of them for examples that I've taken and posted on Instagram. All of these scams start off with an email lead. 9 times out of 10 is what I've experienced. First thing off the bat that you will notice is they're going to ask for a quote for services, and their English is going to be god awful. It's going to have grammar mistakes, spelling mistakes, and they're just going to be asking for, it's like going to be completely weird. Most clients are going to contact you asking about your experience, your services. No, they're just going to want a quote or a rental or how much the DJ, how much you charge per hour. And a lot of times they're gonna hit you and be like, do you accept credit cards? So those are the initial red flags, is that they basically don't ask for any details about your company or what you provide or your experience. They're just asking, hey, do you provide services? And do you accept credit card? That should be flag number one. Now, if you have a conversation with these scammers, they're basically gonna ask for a quote, and they do not care how much you quote. As you guys will see in a couple of these emails that are popping up right now, I know they're a scam, so I'm throwing out 6, 10 grand. I'm just messing with them because I know they're scammers, and they're gonna be like, yes, that's 100%, we can do that, no problem. Also, some other flags. 9 times out of 10, they're not gonna give you any venue location, and if you ask them, be like, hey, I normally like to do a phone call, they're gonna be like, oh, well, I'm actually out on work across the globe or whatever, and our hours don't line up, and I can't work out time to call. Blah, 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 blah. And again, they're gonna leave out a lot of details. They might not even give you a date. It's gonna be very vague. And most clients know all this information. So that's another flag for why this is a scammer. As this scammer email chain continues, they're gonna ask for a favor. And this favor in some sort of form, basically they're gonna need to pay another vendor, right? So they got other vendors for their event. That's another thing, this event doesn't exist, it's all a scam. It's literally all a scam, guys, just get that in your head. But let's continue with this fake event. They're gonna have a vendor, say a venue, a photographer, a band, you name it. That vendor requires them to be paid in cash only. They don't accept credit card or checks, or they're not a legitimate business, so they can't accept it. This person that's contacting you needs to pay this other vendor in cash. So they're gonna want you to overcharge their credit card. Say they need another 2 grand to pay this photographer, right? You're telling them that your invoice, your cost is gonna be 5 grand. 5 grand for the event. They're gonna want you to charge their credit card for 7 grand and then give them cash, 2 grand, to pay this other vendor. Also, this cash, they're gonna want you to like put it in an envelope and send it to them, because you're never actually gonna see this person in person. Now, this is where a lot of people got lost in the email conversations that I was having with these people, and they didn't understand why this is a scam. So, Ricky, they want me to overcharge their card. I'm still getting 5 grand and giving 2 grand out. Two big reasons right here. One, it's somewhat illegal, and also it hurts you tax-wise, because say this was all legit, you overcharge their car by 2 grand, you're gonna pay taxes on income for that additional 2 grand that other vendor doesn't have to pay taxes on. But that's besides the point, because the main point is this credit card that they give you is gonna come up fraud after the payment goes through. Or the credit card is gonna not have the funds or canceled, etc. You get the point. It's a scam, the credit card's not gonna eventually go through. And when that credit card doesn't go through, you're out $2,000 because the credit card company is not gonna give you that $2,000, or they're not gonna give you those funds. You don't get any of that money, and you already sent $2,000 to that client in cash. Now, I will point out in the conversations I had with a lot of you guys on Instagram, some of you guys point out that they've also done this with certified checks. And apparently this is another scam. I haven't ran into it yet, where they're gonna want you to basically be able to take a picture with like your phone deposit of a check, and they're gonna send you that picture of that check, and you're gonna use it to do like a mobile deposit basically. And I've been told that these checks are illegitimate, fraudulent checks basically. Those checks are gonna bounce. Be aware that they've also done this scam with checks and with credit card. But main points for knowing it is a fraud is that whole do me a favor thing, and overall just the common sense that they don't give you any info and they act like no other lead you've heard before. Big promises, guys. There's big promises, big money. Trust me, the first couple times I ran into this, I was like, oh my God, I can make so much money. This is a huge lead. Like, they want all this stuff for like $5,000. I can make so much money. No, like, you get into it, and then they talk about, oh, doing the favor, and illegitimate, and the lack of English, and even all the excuses they give up, even if you, like, you should realize it is a scam, guys. Now, the main point of this video, guys, is to make you aware of these scammers that are out there. Believe it or not, there are scammers in the mobile DJ industry, in the wedding industry in general. There's scammers everywhere, and they're becoming more and more frequent as technology evolves. Now, I also want to point out some good ways to avoid scammers, or to at least basically red flag them off the bat, other than what I was just telling you. Things like establishing on your website that you strongly want them to fill out, like an inquiry form, like HoneyBook has an inquiry form you can put on your website. I know DJ Event Planner has one. If you put those up on your website and kind of have your email is like in the background on like the contact page, 9 times out of 10, they're gonna fill out that inquiry form if they're a legit customer, and the scammers aren't gonna fill it out. Another type of software thing you could do is Calendly. I know DJ Mojo uses this heavily. Actually, if you go to DJ Mojo, my boy's site, you will not find this dude's phone number or email anywhere on his website. You have to schedule a meeting or a phone call with him through Calendly. That right there, you're not gonna get a scammer. Or if you do, it'll be a phone call, and it's like, it's so obvious. Other than the softwares and the inquiry systems though, guys, if you are questioning any sort of email lead that you get, one, look at the two examples I put up here, the two that I got screenshots of, but the English is bad and there's no descriptions. But if you're still questioning, you're like, it could be legit, maybe it's a scammer, ask them if they'll jump on a phone call. Be like, I want to talk about the services and stuff like that, because this is a big thing that you want, or it's a big event, it's a special day, whatever you want to say. Ask them if they'll jump on a phone call. One of two things is going to happen. One, they're just going to avoid it completely, like they're not even going to try and jump on a phone call because they're in some sort of third world country and they can't speak English worth crap, and they're going to pull things like, oh, I'm on work and I'm busy 24/7, or I'm in China so our hours don't line up so we can't do phone calls. A normal client would not give an excuse for a phone call. Or two, maybe they do jump on a phone call with you and their English is going to be just terrible. You're gonna wanna like quiz the heck out of them on their event. What's your location? What's your times? What do you need? How many guests? What type of guests are coming? Just go through the normal stuff. And if they literally struggle to answer all those questions probably, or if they make up bull crap and you could see right through it, you know they're not legit. Hope this video was not too long, guys. I wanted to just bring some awareness to scamming out there. The whole entire video was completely off the top of my head based on some Instagram conversations I had today. Again, follow me on Instagram. But I want to leave it with this, guys. If you have some sort of scams that you have ran into in the DJ industry, leave them down in the comments section down below. If we get enough examples and stuff like that, also DM me on Instagram if you got some other examples that maybe we need to make a follow-up video to discuss some other scams that maybe are happening over on the West Coast versus here on the East Coast. And overall, guys, I don't want to see any of you guys fall for any of these scams. So if you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you get all the amazing, awesome, educational and informational content that we post on this channel, as well as the gig logs. Hit that notification bell, that way you guys are notified whenever we post one of these cool, awesome videos. And like always, guys, my name is DJ Rick Webb. Keep them records spinning, guys, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.